We're shaking, folks. Back with another reaction. Back with some more Beastie Boys. We're moving on to the next tune and their 1992 album, Check Your Head. I did just want to give a shout out to people who've been commenting on these reactions in the last week or so. Anthony in particular, but recently Nathan's commented on a couple. There was someone new today. Let me see. I have the video out. Brian, and he was saying Professor Booty. He was saying you should really look out for that one because that's a good tune. So we got that one coming up. That will be in three more reactions after this one, so very much looking forward to that, and shout out to Brian for giving me the heads up on that one. I did want to mention, I've ordered a copy of Ill Communication. It's supposed to be here in about 10 days, meaning, given the rate I've been doing these, I'll probably finish this album in maybe 2 or 3 days, so there might be about a week gap between Beastie Boys reactions, but, you know, in the meantime, I'll probably do a couple Wu-Tang reactions, or maybe a couple Deltron 3030 reactions. Or just, you know, Del the Funky Homo Sapien. We'll have to see. But I'll have some hip-hop in the intervening week, I promise. Nevertheless, we're up to the next tune in this album, which is called, as I look at Discogs here, Groove Holmes. And like the earlier tune, Lighten Up, it features the cuica and congas played by Juanito Vasquez, which tells me that maybe this is going to have some more of that Latin funk kind of flavor. Really enjoying the diversity of the album. I'll just keep saying that. But in particular, I love the way they blend hip-hop with different elements, meaning, like, there have been tracks that were sort of straight-up hip-hop, so What You Want is, I think, maybe the best example of that. But there's other tracks that have had, like, rhyming and flow, but not, like, in a typical, like, hip-hop idiom. It'll have more of a funk flavor. It'll have some, again, like jazzy, kind of like Latin vibes. Like, their ability to mix different styles even within a single track is really standing out to me. So, once again, big ups to the guys. Let's get to it. This is Groove Holmes on the album Check Your Head, 1992 by Beastie Boys. Oh, got more of that like green onions kind of feel. Walking down like a Miami street in the afternoon. Like the organ-like thing I'm hearing? Because congas are drums, yeah? Those are like, and I hear like, but that tells me maybe the cuica is this kind of organ-sounding instrument? I mean, I would think this was Santana. If I didn't know by this point in this album that the Beastie Boys were as musically talented and wide-ranging as they are, I'd be like, oh, so this is like Ozo Motley? This is Santana? Like, what is this? Like, no, dude, it's Beastie Boys. What? And they have more like just grooves, like jams, than I do. They clearly like to just play sometimes. Everything's kind of popping in for like a little moment, a little note, and then all kind of like reaching around each other sonically. Those are the congas, yeah? This is worth blowing a skate video. Felt like at the beginning and the end there, it was like, you know, like a live recording, so there was like caught audio of them just talking like on the set. or in the studio. But yeah, that was dope. I enjoyed that. As I said, I love the way they seem to like to jam a bit. Like, sometimes even, you know, in a song that does actually have verses. But then other times, this is like the third or fourth, like, fully instrumental tune, if I can remember correctly. So, yeah, big ups to them for enjoying to play, not just to have the mic in their hands. I didn't realize that quite as much, even if I did know that some of their earliest stuff was in sort of like a hardcore sort of punk idiom. So I knew they liked to play instruments on some level, but I didn't realize they liked to like jam and just, you know, kind of let it explore the space. So yeah, it's dope. Let me know what you think of this one. Let me know if you know more about, what is it, Juanito, what is his last name? Juanito Vasquez, yeah. Let me see, Discogs does have a page for him here. Let me see, oh shit. It just says percussionist. It literally just says percussionist. But it does seem like he has an album that came out in 1990 on Afro-Cuban Records called Cuba and Bicicleta y a las Naciones Unidas. But yeah, it's obviously it looks like all the songs are in Spanish. So, oh wow, there's only one copy available and it's for $50. So you're not going to be able to get it cheap. But apparently he did make an album of his own right around this time, you know, a couple years before this album came out. So maybe that's how he came to the Beastie Boys' attention, or maybe they already knew him. Shout it out if you're familiar. But yeah, that was pretty cool. Only a few tracks to go. As I said, looking forward to Professor Booty now, given that Brian shouted it out. So we'll have to see what that one's about. Anyway, thank you for listening and watching. I'll see you next time.